Come on, let's go. Let's go. Come on. We don't have time.
What do you tell my wife?
It's an almost scientific fact that we Filipinos love our light, fluffy romantic comedies, our saccharine sweet K-dramas, and our meaty infidelity stories. But too much of a good thing can be a bad thing, especially when it comes to your entertainment diet. So why not cleanse your palate with a dark, twisty thriller? If that's the kind of palate cleanser you're after, have I got a humdinger for you. This is Andrew Paredes with another work-from-home edition of Let's Get Real, and let's get into The Bridge. In 2011, Danish TV hit upon a blockbuster of a cross-border premise. A corpse is found on the bridge, straddling the border of Sweden and Denmark. And that's just the half of it, no pun intended. It turns out that the corpse was situated purposefully so that the crime had to be investigated under the jurisdictions of both Sweden and Denmark, but that the corpse was actually made up of two victims, one from Sweden and the other from Denmark. And from this premise was born The Bridge, a story that resonated so deeply in these times of geopolitical strife that it spawned adaptations all over Europe. Now, the idea spread across the Atlantic and made its way to the Americas when Hulu did their own adaptation of The Bridge, set on the border between US and Mexico. And in 2018, Southeast Asia finally caught on to the idea when Viu produced its own version of The Bridge, featuring a corpse that was discovered on the Tuas Second Link Bridge linking Singapore and Malaysia. Now, any fan of crime procedurals will tell you that the crime is only half of the story. The other half involves the protagonists who are seeking to uncover the truth behind the crime.
You're the one who said we needed him. What did you think that would mean?
And in the Southeast Asian version of The Bridge, we have two very intriguing protagonists indeed. Singaporean actress Rebecca Lim plays Detective Operative Serena Teo, who is this stiff, by-the-book operative lacking in social skills and emotional intelligence, who is forced to work with her Malaysian counterpart, a laid-back family man named Megat Jamil, played by actor Bron Palare.
And the SOP while in Singapore,
didn't you see she was upset when we came in? She was crying.
I don't care about her emotional state, I just need answers.
Now, like any good noir thriller, the investigation into a specific crime opens up into an exploration of deep and dark human impulses like violence, greed, and ambition unchecked by any sort of moral code, and even further into larger systemic corruption involving large social crimes like human trafficking and money laundering and domestic abuse.
No matter how you try to clean dirty money, the stench never goes away.
All right, let's move.
Now, another interesting aspect of the Southeast Asian version of The Bridge is that, unlike its counterparts set in the Northern Hemisphere, especially the Scandinavian version, which is set in a region of the Earth that is shrouded in darkness like half of the year, the Southeast Asian version is obviously set in the tropics. And the light in the tropics is flat, it is harsh, it is unflattering. It covers nearly every aspect of the storytelling, which you would think is counterintuitive to the very idea of a noir, aka dark thriller. But by leaning into the harsh, unflattering light of the tropics, The Bridge makes this supposition that these systemic crimes are even more disturbing because they can be committed and go undetected, even in the harsh, all-encompassing light of its setting.
Who found out that?
It's too convenient to rule out Megat as a suspect. Tell me I'm wrong.
What are you doing here?
Now, if all of this feels a bit too heavy for you, or if it feels like a world away from the light and sunny Korean romantic comedies that you have been devouring all during this quarantine, let me assure you that The Bridge is paced with such propulsive energy and such adrenaline-pumping force that you barely realize the time zipping by. Now, as revelations get parsed out in the plot, even more questions arise and cliffhangers abound. And what's even more exciting about season 2 of The Bridge Bridge is that it feels more ambitious. It wants to include more of the Southeast Asian palette into its canvas. In this current season, there is a third operative, an Indonesian International Crimes Division agent played by Aryo Bayu, who has a very personal stake in getting these crimes solved, which is another reason why this second season feels more self-assured, because it feels like the creators took the lessons of season one, which featured subplots that ultimately did not contribute to the larger story that was being told, and took its sweet time in establishing the personal stakes of the agents in solving this case. Now, I would highly recommend that you catch up on season one by binging season one on Viu, just so you get to know the agents and you find out where they are in the beginning of season two.
Okay, this whole time,
he's got everything he needed for the plan.
Are you watching?
Kill my partner, kill my friend! How a cop should I be?
So again, I recommend that you catch up on The Bridge, binge the first season on Viu, and new episodes of season 2 get uploaded on Viu every Monday evening. So this has been Ano Paredes. This has been my latest recommendation, and I'll talk to you soon.